Hello, curious minds. We are back with yet another video for you to quench your thirst for all things space. So buckle right in, because we are going on a flight to the stars. Before we move on though, make sure to press the subscribe button, and do not forget to hit the bell icon to never miss out on any of our latest space niche videos. In this video today, we are going to bring you up to date with the recent developments in the crazy world of space. Boeing's CST-100 Starliner capsule has joined up with its rocket ride. Technicians stacked Starliner atop its United Launch Alliance ULA Atlas V rocket Wednesday, May the 4th, at ULA's Vertical Integration Facility at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. ULA and Boeing are gearing up for the Orbital Flight Test 2, a crucial uncrewed test mission to the International Space Station that's scheduled to launch on May the 19th. If all goes well with OFT2, Starliner will likely be cleared to carry NASA astronauts to and from the orbiting lab in the near future. Boeing and NASA say the Starliner spacecraft is ready for a do-over flight with the second crewed test mission of the spacecraft. Starliner rolled to the VIF Wednesday from Boeing's commercial crew and cargo processing facility at NASA's Kennedy Space Center, which is next door to Cape Canaveral's Space Force Station. The capsule made the trip atop ULA's motorized payload transporter, traveling at a top speed of 5 miles per hour, ULA representatives said. Approaching the VIF, the transporter maneuvered up to the 30-story building's doorway and parked, ULA wrote in a statement on Wednesday. A 4-point lifting sling called the Handling Fixture Hoist Tool was connected to the Starliner for the overhead crane to carefully raise the spacecraft onto the Atlas V waiting inside the VIF, aboard its mobile launch platform. As its name suggests, OF2 will be Boeing's second try at an uncrewed test flight to the ISS. The first, which lifted off in December 2019, was cut short after Starliner suffered several software glitches and was unable to meet up with the orbiting lab. OF2, which will use a different Starliner vehicle than the original OFT, has encountered some issues of its own. The mission was originally supposed to launch last August, but pre-flight checks revealed stuck valves in the capsule service module. After a lengthy investigation, Boeing and NASA teams identified the cause. Oxidizer reacted with humidity in the air, generating nitric acid, and then creating corrosion products that impeded valve function, and came up with mitigation measures. And Starliner is now getting ready for liftoff once again. Boeing holds a contract with NASA's Commercial Crew program and aims to begin flying astronauts with Starliner towards the end of 2022, if OFT2 goes well. SpaceX holds a similar deal and is already up and running with its Dragon capsule and Falcon 9 rockets. Elon Musk's company launched its fourth operational astronaut mission for NASA, known as Crew 4, on April 27th. 9 months have passed since a standard pre-flight check of the spacecraft, then sitting atop a rocket on the launch pad in Florida, found that 13 of 24 oxidizer valves within Starliner's propulsion system were stuck. The discovery was made within hours of liftoff. OFT-2, which will use a different Starliner vehicle than the original OFT, has encountered some issues of its own. The mission was originally supposed to launch last August, but pre-flight checks revealed stuck valves in the capsule's service module. Since then, engineers and technicians at Boeing and NASA have worked to fully understand why the valves were stuck and to fix the problem. They found that the dinitrogen tetroxide oxidizer that had been loaded onto the spacecraft 46 days prior to the launch had combined with ambient humidity to create nitric acid, which had started the process of corrosion inside the valve's aluminium housing. On Tuesday, during a teleconference with reporters, officials from Boeing and NASA discussed the steps they have to take to ameliorate the problem from Starliner's upcoming test flight. Michelle Parker, Vice President and Deputy General Manager of Boeing Space and Launch, said the valves remain the same on the vehicle, but the technicians have sealed up pathways by which moisture might get inside the propulsion system. They are also purging moisture from the valves, using nitrogen gas, and loading propellants onto Starliner closer to the launch. With those mitigation factors undertaken, Starliner will soon be stacked on top of an Atlas V rocket built by United Launch Alliance. Starliner was in fact due to roll out to the Atlas V launch complex in Florida on Wednesday. But Boeing said the rollout was paused due to a hydraulic leak on United Launch Alliance's transport vehicle. So it goes with Boeing's start and stop efforts to bring Starliner into service. The company has been working on the vehicle since at least 2010, when it was called Crew Space Transport 100, or CST-100. Starliner made its debut flight in December 2019, but problems cropped up minutes after liftoff when the spacecraft captured the wrong mission elapsed time from its Atlas V launch vehicle. It also had difficulty communicating with ground systems flight controllers at NASA and Boeing, who were able to restore communications with Starliner and help it reach orbit. However, because of the propellant spent during these activities, Starliner was unable to complete its primary objective, demonstrating a safe docking with the International Space Station. There were also problems during the return journey to Earth. Another software error caught and fixed just a few hours before the vehicle returned to Earth through the atmosphere would have caused thrusters on the Starliner service module to fire in the wrong manner. The vehicle was nearly lost a second time. These problems led NASA to declare the first Starliner test flight a high visibility close call and set off a years-long investigation and deep dive into Starliner's software problems. Boeing agreed to pay for a second test flight at a cost of $410 million and eventually readied the Orbital Flight Test 2 mission that reached the pad in the summer of 2021. Then, the valves had its sticky valve issue. Finally, after all of that, the company has Starliner back on the pad, ready for a do-over of the do-over launch. NASA, of course, presently has SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft to get its astronauts to and from the International Space Station. Crew Dragon has flown 5 largely flawless crewed missions since mid-2020. But with tensions high between the United States and Russia, NASA would very much like to have a second crew transportation option to reach the station. That means there is high interest at NASA in Starliner's second test. Success with this test flight would likely set Boeing up to fly to the space station for the first time early in 2023. With this, we have come to the end of our video. Congrats on having such a great attention span. Let us know how excited you are about the new ventures of space and SpaceX down in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe for similar content. Until we meet next time.